There's something called the CIE LAB space, sometimes called lab space, but LAB actually, where L is luminance, and then as you change the A and the B, you end up with different colors. I'm going to use the word color now instead of the more technical words later, which we'll use. So here you have a luminance of 25%, so it's kind of darker, and you see the greenish, reddish, and bluish things as you move around, and in the middle is kind of gray. Right, and as luminance gets brighter, the middle gets brighter, and you get these lighter variations in color. And so that's called the LAB color space. And the idea is that you've got luminance, and you've got sort of how saturated the color is, and actually what we call the color, but what is typically referred to as the hue. And that's sometimes defined, you can think of the color as a three-dimensional volume of one sort or another, and you'll see there's a whole bunch of ways of representing it. But the idea is that one way of thinking about it is that down here is dark, up at the top is brighter, and as you move around the circle, so it goes through 0 to 360 around again, is what's referred to as the hue, okay? And as you move outside, things become purer in color. All right. So two systems that people use a lot to talk about these things are called sometimes hue, saturation, and lightness, or sometimes hue, saturation, and value. There are all different kinds of color spaces. These two can be drawn as sort of these thick cylinders. So down here again at the bottom, things are dark. Up at the top, things are light. In hue, saturation, and lightness, the whole top is white, which I think, by the way, is an awful representation. I'll tell you why in a second. Down, the whole thing in the bottom is all black. And as you go around, you get different colors. That's what you can see around here, different hues. And as you go from the middle to the edge, you get more and more saturated. So in the middle, everything is gray. It goes from black to white through gray.